Dear students, now we are going to discuss the mechanism of oxidation of NADH and FADH produced during complete oxidation of a glucose molecule and how this oxidation is responsible for synthesis of ATP molecule, that is called as oxidative phosphorylation here. So mechanism of oxidation of NADH. So first one, oxidation of NADH. Okay, right. So in the textbook, the given one is NADH produced in mitochondrial matrix. It was given like that. But this mechanism is applicable to all NADH, not only NADH coming from link reaction and TCA cycle, but also NADH coming from glycolysis. Same process. Okay, so first of all, take a inner mitochondrial membrane, crusty region, mitochondrial crusty. So this is a inner mitochondrial membrane at the crest. Here I am writing. Mitochondrial crest. Plural, it is plural. Mitochondrial crest, folding of a inner mitochondrial membrane into the matrix, and this one is mitochondrial matrix, MM, mitochondrial matrix. This one intermembrane space. Okay, so take one molecule of NADH, oxidation of one molecule of NADH. So take one molecule of NADH here, NADH. And you should know that what about the total number of NADH possible out of a complete oxidation of one glucose molecule? Okay, right? So here, complex involved is, that is also well known to you, that complex is complex one. This is complex one. So here I'm writing, complex one. C1 means complex one. Okay, so what are the components of complex one? Enzyme is NADH dehydrogenase with certain number of iron sulfur centers. So now NADH is oxidized into one molecule of NAD plus. Okay, so now electrons available from the oxidation of that. Two electrons. This is an electron transport system. So now one by one electrons accepted by here F M N, flavin mononucleotide. So for the reduction of FMN, one electron, 2H plus required. Remember that one. Okay. So now oxidation of that one and reduction of 2H plus one electron. Next, same process, one more electron, 2H plus. One electron, 2H plus. Remember this one. One electron, 2H plus. So like that, how many H plus required? 4H plus. One electron, 2H plus. So FMN is reduced into FMNH2 with the help of one electron, 2H plus. Second time, second electron, 2H plus. Remember that one. And now these electrons are passed on to iron sulfur centers. Right? So what about the number of H plus here? 2 plus 2, 4 H plus. So reduced oxidized. Reduced oxidized. So now what about the protons liberated into intermembrane space? 4H plus. Here ratio is, remember, one electron, 2H plus. Remember this one. One electron, 2H plus. So complex one is a gateway for the oxidation of any NADH. So out of two electrons passed through complex one, what about the total number of protons translocated into intermembrane space? Four. One is to two. Two electrons, 4H plus. Remember this one. Okay. Now, two electrons accepted by one by one. Two electrons accepted by one by one. UB quinone, UQ I'm writing, UB quinone. Here also one electron, 2H plus, one electron, 2H plus, one electron, 2H plus. Okay. 2H plus, 2H plus. Okay, so that is reduced into UQ H2, immediately oxidizing. Right? So don't forget one electron, 2H plus, one electron, 2H plus. Okay, so from the oxidation of that, now next electron acceptor is complex three, third complex. So now electrons one by one. Electron one and electron two electrons accepted by next electron acceptor, that is a cytochrome B. Next, iron sulfur center. Next, cytochrome C1. Reduced oxidized. Okay, so one by one electron. Right? So now, out of two electrons, what about the number of H plus translocated into intermembrane space? Here also 4H plus. This is very, very important. One electron, 2H plus. Here also, out of two electrons, what about the total number of protons translocated here? Four. Through the cytochrome complex. That is a complex three with the help of a ubiquinone, right? Now electrons accepted by next complex. What is that complex? That complex is a cytochrome complex. That cytochrome complex is with a cytochrome B, cytochrome C1, right? So here electrons are coming from this complex. Next electron acceptor is cytochrome C. Cytochrome C is a mobile electron carrier between complex 3 and complex 4. So here for the oxidation of NADH second complex, complex 2 is not required. Bypass it. Yesterday, I wrote here one flask shaped structure. Avoid it. Don't take that one into picture here. Even though in your textbook, it was given there. Don't write that one here. Okay, to understand the concept. So complex 2 is not involved. So now 2 electrons accepted by cytochrome C. Cytochrome C is a mobile electron acceptor or carrier, mobile electron carrier between complex 3 and 4. And what about the location of a cytochrome C? Towards a intermembrane space, means outer side of the inner mitochondrial membrane, facing the intermembrane space. Now, these 2 electrons accepted by next electron acceptor. Okay, so that complex is complex 4. Okay, right? So now 2 electrons accepted by copper containing protein A. Next, cytochrome A. Next, cytochrome A3. Next, copper containing protein B. So now 2 electrons are available here. Okay, right? So complex 3 is called as cytochrome C reductase. As complex 3 is able to reduce cytochrome C, this complex is called as cytochrome C reductase. And this complex is accepting electrons from cytochrome C, means causing oxidation of this. So complex 4 is called as cytochrome C oxidase, right? Now, out of a transportation of 2 electrons, what about the number of protons translocated here? Here 2 only. Actually 4, but out of 4, 2 are utilized here. How? 2 electrons, half O2, oxygen atom, plus 2H+. Okay, so oxygen atom is reduced into one molecule of H2O. One molecule of NADH, one molecule of H2O. Right? So complex 2 is not required. So what are the complexes required for the oxidation of NADH? Complex 1 required. Next, complex 3 required. Complex 4 required for the completion of electron transport system. Next, ubiquinone required, cytochrome C required. Next, 5th complex also required. But 5th complex is not concerned with the transportation of electrons. It is concerned with the transportation of or translocation of protons only. So this one is a F0. Okay, so that is a ATP synthase complex. So this is a complex 5. 5th complex is concerned with synthesis of ATP molecule. So according to Peter Mitchell's chemiosmotic mechanism, ATP synthase complex is a protein, transmembrane protein with 2 parts. Stalk part, which is completely embedded within the membrane, and head part. So this one is a head part. So head is into the mitochondrial matrix, head part. So this one is a F0, F1. So some part is inside the membrane, remaining is into the mitochondrial matrix. So that is an integral protein concerned with the transportation of protons. So according to Here, what about the total number of protons accumulated? 4 plus 4 plus 2. So total accumulation is 10H plus. So because of more number of H plus, it is a continuous process. What about the charge in the intermembrane space? Positive charge increases, more proton concentration, and less number of protons here, negative charge. Okay, so negative charge, positive charge. So charge difference, electro potential gradient, electro potential gradient, charge difference, positive and negative charge. So after completion of oxidation of NADH, many protons are accumulated within the intermembrane. So more positive charge, less positive charge. So according to that, take a negative charge, positive charge. What about pH here? What about H plus increasing? H plus increasing means what about pH? Negative logarithm of hydrogen ion concentration. And what about here? What about H plus concentration? Declining. And what about pH increasing? Remember this one. Okay, right? So now 4 plus 4 plus 2, 10. What about the feet of 10H plus? So less number of protons, more number of protons. Across the membrane or between mitochondrial matrix and intermembrane space, proton concentration gradient is created. More number of protons, less number of protons. According to chemiosmosis, to synthesize ATP, what are the requirements? Membrane, proton concentration gradient, and ATP synthase complex. So now, these protons are going back to mitochondrial matrix. Okay, so each time 2H plus only. 2H plus account for synthesis of one ATP molecule. So during transportation of 2H plus, some amount of energy is liberated. That energy is used by this complex to synthesize one ATP molecule from one ADP and inorganic phosphate. So how many H plus? 2H plus. How many ATP molecules? 1. So 2 is to 1 ratio. So out of 10 H plus, how many H plus are involved? Only 6 H plus involved. And remaining 4 H plus are maintained, concerned with the maintenance of a proton concentration gradient. Okay, so 6 H plus. 6H plus divided by 2H plus. How many ATP possible? 3 molecules of ATP. So from oxidation of any NADH, number of ATP molecules synthesized is 3. According to 2 is to 1 ratio. 2H plus, 2H plus, 2H plus. 3 sets, for example. 2H plus, 2H plus, 2H plus, 3 sets to understand the concept. How many ATP possible? 3 molecules of ATP. Okay, so that's about a mechanism of oxidation of NADH. In the textbook, the given one is mechanism of oxidation of NADH produced within the mitochondrial matrix. Okay, it is applicable to NADH coming from glycolysis also. We will discuss that one at the end, not now. Okay, so there is about a flow of electrons during oxidation of NADH produced during glycolysis, link reaction TC also. So according to textbook statement, from oxidation of one NADH, how many ATP molecules are possible? Go for 3 according to NCERT, means according to NEET. Right? So there is about a flow of electrons. So to understand this concept, you should know what are the components involved. So for the oxidation of NADH, complex 1 involved, 3 involved, 4 involved, 5 required for ATP synthesis. Along with that, ubiquinone required, cytochrome C required. Complex 2 is not required. So complex 2 is not concerned with oxidation of NADH. It is concerned with oxidation of FADH only. We'll see that one separately. So here, we studied the mechanism of oxidation of NADH. Right? So what are the complexes not required for oxidation of NADH? Only complex 2. That is a succinate dehydrogenase enzyme concerned complex. Don't use that one here. Of course, in your textbook, it was given here. Okay, so if both are given simultaneously, it leads to a lot of confusion. So divide it. You can understand very easily, right? So don't forget that 2 electrons, 4H plus. 1:2 ratio. Here also, 1:2 ratio. Here, actually 4, but out of 4, only 2 are accumulated, remaining 2 are here. And out of 10H plus, take 6H plus for ATP synthesis. Remaining 4H plus are able to maintain proton concentration gradient to synthesize ATP molecule continuously. So here, continuous synthesis of ATP is mandatory. So that's why always proton concentration gradient must be maintained. More protons, less number of protons. So that's about oxidation of NADH. Now, simply, now I'm going to explain what about the total number of NADH and how many ATP molecules possible with the help of this system, right? So if we take one molecule of NADH, and a half O2 oxygen atom, one atom is enough, plus 3 molecules of ADP, plus 3 molecules of inorganic phosphates. Okay, so ATP synthase enzyme. ATP synthase enzyme. So one molecule of NAD plus oxidized form plus one molecule of H2O plus 3 molecules of ATP. Remember this one. So this is a molecule one. This is an atom, one atom only. Okay, so like that, how many NADH are available? So, total number of NADH, 10 molecules of NADH. 10 NADH. Out of 12 or not? Total number of reduced coenzymes, 12 out of 12, 10 are the NADH. Okay. Now, 5 O2 molecules are 10 half O2s. 10 molecules, 10 half O2s. Or directly take a 5 O2 molecules. Next, plus 1:3, 10:3, 30 ADP plus 30 inorganic phosphates. Use rice, 10 molecules of NAD plus 1 NADH, 1 H2O molecule, 1:1. So 10 means 10 H2O molecules. 10 H2O plus 1:3. 10:3. 30 ATP molecules. 30 ATP molecules. Okay, so here 30 ATP molecules are produced by means of OP, oxidative phosphorylation. Oxidative phosphorylation. Synthesis of ATP during oxidation and reduction. Okay, so here oxidation of NADH, reduction of oxygen into H2O molecule. So maximum amount of energy is liberated in the form of NADH, right? So there is about oxidation of NADH. And now second one, oxidation of FADH, right? Now, second one, oxidation of FADH2 or FADH. How many molecules are available? 2 molecules. Okay, so now, what are the complexes required? Complex 1 not involved. So start from complex 2. Flask shaped structure. Okay, so this one is a intermembrane space. Crest region, mitochondrial crest region. Rest apart. Mitochondrial matrix. Okay, so this is a complex 2. Complex 2. Now, here take one molecule of FADH2. In your textbook, succinic acid to fumaric acid was given. Follow like that, no problem, but take a FADH2. Follow according to textbook. Succinic acid to fumaric acid. What they're explaining? They're explaining TCA cycle reaction. Succinic acid to fumaric acid. There are one molecule of FADH2 is produced out of one succinic acid converted into fumaric acid. So FAD plus. And enzyme is a succinate dehydrogenase. Succinate dehydrogenase. So total number of electrons available. 2 electrons available. And enzyme is succinate dehydrogenase. Succinate dehydrogenase is concerned with both a TCA cycle and electron transport system. And that enzyme is not present in mitochondrial matrix. Present in crust region and able to regulate both the reactions. That is very, very important enzyme. Okay. And here, prosthetic group is a FAD, iron sulfur center. So now, 2 electrons accepted by FAD, right? So now these electrons are passing through iron sulfur centers and the next electron acceptor is ubiquinone. So 2 electrons accepted by this one. Okay, so here 4H plus you have to take. 4H plus accepted by EQ. Now that is reduced into UQH2. Immediately oxidized. Okay, so from the oxidation of weight. So take here UQ. Okay, accepting electrons. 2 electrons accepted one by one. 2 electrons Next, 4H plus also. 4H plus also. Reduced into UQH. So same process, immediately oxidized. So here complex involved is third complex. Complex 3. What is that complex? Cytochrome B iron sulfur center cytochrome C1. So now two electrons accepted by it. Two electrons are passing through one by one, passing through. Okay, so now two electrons are available here, right? And a 4H plus translocated into intermembrane space. And don't take a complex one. Complex one is not involved here. Okay, so the difference between oxidation of NADH and FADH regarding involvement of complex is, complex one is for NADH only. Complex two is for FADH only. And rest of the electron carriers are common for both. Uncommon is complex one and two. Remaining all are common. So what about the number of H plus translocated? 4H plus. Now, these two electrons accepted by cytochrome C, mobile electron carrier, between complex 3 and 4 here. So take complex 4. Fourth complex. What is that fourth complex? Cytochrome C oxidase. That is copper containing protein A, cytochrome A, cytochrome A3, copper containing protein B, and ultimately two electrons available here. Okay, so two electrons, right? So cytochrome C is a mobile electron carrier between complex 3 and a fourth complex. So this one is a fourth complex. Okay, so here also same process, two electrons, half O2 plus 2H plus 1H2O molecule. Here also, out of two electrons, 4H plus, but only two are translocated, are accumulated. Remaining 2H plus consumed here to reduce half O2 into 1H2O molecule. Okay, right? So what about the total number of H plus available? 6H plus. Now, this complex, what is this complex? ATP synthase complex. F0, this one, F1. So here, out of a 4H plus, how many are involved? Take 4H plus only. 2H plus are retained here. Okay, so each time 2H plus passing through. This is a facilitated diffusion. Facilitated diffusion, more to less. Transporter of H plus protons. So 2H plus transported. Okay, so what about the number of ATP molecules? Two ATP molecules from two molecules of ADP plus two molecules of inorganic phosphate. Okay, so four are responsible for two ATP molecules, means 4 by 2 molecules of ATP. Okay, so during oxidation of FADH2, what are the complexes involved? Complex 2 involved, 3 involved, 4 involved, and 5th one. This is not concerned with transportation of electrons, only protons. Ubiquinone involved, cytochrome C involved. So here complex 1 is not involved, right? 4 plus 2, 6 only. And in the case of NADH, 4 plus 2, 10. Right? So that is about oxidation of FADH2. Right? During aerobic respiration, what about the total number of FADH produced? Two molecules. Now take those two molecules here. First, take one molecule, FADH2 plus half O2 plus two molecules of ADP, two molecules of inorganic phosphate, and ATP synthase complex or synthase enzyme. Okay, right? So one molecule of FAD plus oxidized form, one molecule of H2O plus two molecules of ATP. 1:2. So total number of FADH2, two molecules of FADH2. Okay, so here one oxygen molecule, O2 I'm writing, oxygen molecule, one molecule, plus four ADP plus four inorganic phosphates, same enzyme, two molecules of FAD plus two molecules of H2O plus four molecules of ATP. Okay, produced by means of OP, oxidative phosphorylation. Oxidative phosphorylation. So total number of FADH2, two molecules of FADH2 per molecule to ATP. Total number of ATP from this one is 4. So like this. What about the total number of reduced coenzymes out of one molecule of glucose completely oxidized? Reduced coenzymes. How many? Total 12. Out of 12, 10 are the NADH, 2 are the FADH, 10 × 3 ATP molecules, 10 × 2 ATP molecules, 30 ATP molecules, 4 ATP molecules. How many? 34 ATP molecules produced by OP. 34. Okay, oxidative phosphorylation ATP. How many? 34 ATP. Out of oxidation of 12 molecules of reduced coenzymes. So initially we discussed the oxidation of NADH. This part initially we completed. And the second one, this we completed. These two together. How many? 34 ATP molecule produced by means of OP, oxidative phosphorylation. So highest number of ATP molecules are produced by means of OP, oxidative phosphorylation. Right? Next. And small comparison between NEET versus MCET regarding ATP production during aerobic respiration. Okay, so 10 molecules of NADH into 3, 30 ATP molecules. Two molecules of FADH into 2, four molecules of ATP. Next, SLP, six molecules of ATP. Total 34 plus 6, 40 ATP molecules, total production. I will give you a shortcut later. Total ATP production. But in the case of MCET, NADH, 8 molecules of NADH, 8 molecules of NADH is coming from mitochondrial matrix, link reaction and Krebs cycle. 8 into 3, 24 ATP. And the second one, 2 molecules of NADH from cytoplasm, cytosolic, glycolysis concerned, into 2, 4 ATP molecules. And third one, FADH to ASTs, 2 molecules of FADH into 2, 4 molecules of ATP. How many? 24, 4, 28, 32. So 32 plus fourth one, SLP. How many? 6 ATP. Total ATP? 38. See the difference. Here, according to NEET, go for 40. Reason? From NADH, how many ATP possible? 3 ATP, 30. But what about here? NADH coming from mitochondrial matrix, linked in the TCS cycle, 8 into 3. But what about NADH coming from glycolysis, 2 into 2 only? This is the difference. Okay, so now net gain of ATP. Okay, so 40 minus 2 ATP consumed during glycolysis. So net is 38 ATP molecules. And again, I will explain you, don't worry. 38. So here, net gain is 38 minus 2 consumed is 36. Okay, so that's about net availability of energy for metabolic reactions. If it is NEET, follow this one. If it is MCET, follow this one. Right? So out of 40 ATP molecules, 34 ATP molecules are produced by means of OP, oxidative phosphorylation. 6 are produced by means of SLP. And here, what about the total number of ATP produced by means of OP? 32. Here 34, there 32. Difference is 2. Reason, here you are taking 3 ATP molecules. 30 plus 4. Here 34. Here 24 plus 4, 28 only. Here 30. See the difference. 10 into 3, 8 into 3, 2 into 2 only. This is very, very important. Is it clear? So that is about oxidation of NADH and FADH with the help of electron transport system concerned with oxidative phosphorylation.